And would you now please welcome your special guest ring announcer for the Final Four Elimination Match, Heart of a Champion, Johnny Omar Lerman!
Thank you. Jersey, weighing in at 136 pounds, ladies and gentlemen,
Black. think you know what the hell you just did wrong. Don't act like you stupid. Get with the damn program. Announce me the way I'm supposed to be announced.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing your former two-time New South Heavyweight Champion, Baron Black.
Some people.
Oh! Thank you. Johnny is really feeling it right now. He's the only man vertical in the Hoss finals. So confident. Oh, Baron's gonna learn today. I like it. Oh no. Oh no.
Oh
God. Oh, this isn't good at all. This is not good at all. No, no.
Oh wow.
He's out.
So he eliminates Cheeseburger and then quickly Baron puts him out.
Donnie was my pick.
And wow, Baron almost has the road paved for him here.
Yeah, I mean, this is pretty much a foregone conclusion here. Well, the crowd hasn't given up on him, that's for sure. Baron almost looks disgusted that he has to.
But, yeah, oh, certainly will.
Man, I'm telling you, man, we have.
Baron fighting back, but he definitely didn't see that coming.
Man, we have got a fiery Cabana Man down on our hands tonight.
It's going to go a long way in putting that fire out, though.
Yeah. I mean, he has been, he come into this match, oh my God, with the injuries from last night, earlier tonight. Then he's been powerbombed on the ring apron. He's been powerbombed through a table. I mean, Baron now trying to remove that protective tape.
Oh, looks like it's pretty well it made it ineffective,
yeah,
anyway.
It definitely is.
Oh,
oh, look at that.
Going man. Vader on him.
Oh. You know, you talked about it in an earlier matchup, you know, at what point does a referee need to end one of these matches to protect someone against themselves? Just when you say that,
oh, wow.
Man, Dan, my God. Look at this.
I had to knock himself out silly there.
He is.
Short forearms.
I was saying those blows didn't quite have the effect that Baron's did. But,
oh.
What a clothesline.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
He might have decaffeinated him.
Definitely.
Might have busted him open there.
Just when it looked like CMD was going to fight back and have a chance. I don't know. That clothesline was brutal.
Still showing that will, though.
He is. Look at him. Very defiant.
Screw your destiny.
Listen to that.
Oh. You know, Cabana Mandan might believe it's his destiny. Oh. Oh, and he goes to the other side again. Make it three times.
Wow.
Baron, I don't know how Cabana Mandan's able to stand, and he finally goes to his face there. Both men down.
I mean, he's.
Baron exerted some force there, but not able to take
it. He will not stay down, Matthew. I mean, look at him. Firing back. I mean, I don't think anybody would think any less of him if he, you know, called it a day after all the punishment he's taken. But look at this.
Trying to chop Baron down like a tree. Cabana Mandan been around the wrestling game for a long time now. Definitely some of the most intensity I've seen out of him.
I've never seen him this intense.
Oh!
Oh, my God, another buckle bomb.
That might take the intensity right out of him.
God, just release power bomb there.
Oh!
Look at that!
Wow, how did Cabana Mandan kick out of that?
That's just sure willpower right there.
It landed almost directly on the back there where the tape was.
I mean, I think he's just running on pure adrenaline and willpower because physically there is no reason he should have been able to kick out of that. That was amazing.
Baron almost, I don't know if that's laughter from real humor or if it's more like, I just don't know what to do. More of a Walter White kind of chuckle.
Listen to him. See him need his trash talking, Baron Black.
I don't know where
Black
this guy is.
Baron almost seems amused by it.
Cabana Mandan fighting back. Wow. Still throwing those feet.
Fighting back any way he can.
Baron.
Like I said, I don't think anybody would think less of him if he just rolled out of the ring and left right now. But he's not going to do that. He's going to...
Getting backed into a corner, though. Oh, forearms.
I don't know that maybe Dump Sanders or one of his friends should maybe come throw in the towel for him for his...
I'm surprised we haven't seen
it. Look at this. Wow. I can't believe... Oh, my God. Hey, he's still standing. Look at that. That is crazy.
The better man, Dan. Right.
Look at that, fired Dan up. Look at him.
Who is this man?
And I think winning back his identity has ignited a brand new fire in CMD that we've never seen before.
Those headbutts are brutal.
I don't think this is funny to Baron Black anymore like it was a minute or so ago.
You got to be questioning what he can do here. Wow, in one shot, just decks him. But he's unable to take advantage. See him.
Oh, look at that.
Breaker.
Big knee lift. Russian leg sweep.
Quick fire succession there out of Cabana Mandan. Oh, the old go-to. But what can he do
vintage
here?
Vintage Cabana Mandan, if you will.
Cover. Oh! Not a whole lot of leverage there.
Yeah, but not as strong of a kick out from Baron Black as you would have had a few minutes ago.
Crowd getting behind Cabana Mandan, lowering that knee pad now.
When Donnie Primetime got pinned, it was just assumed that it wouldn't take him but a couple of minutes to dispense the Cabana Mandan.
This part of the match lasted almost as long as the part.
That's right.
Cabana Mandan really showing some guts here and in control. Reversal.
Oh, no.
Uh-oh. Looking for a belly-to-belly? Oh!
Oh, my gosh.
This ragdolls Cabana Mandan.
I thought he might actually go for a bear hug with those injured ribs, but... At this point in the match, I don't know that Baron has the strength to just hold him there like that.
That would take as much out of him as it would Cabana Mandan, I believe, at this point.
Baron keeps telling Cabana Mandan that this is his destiny, to be the Hall's champion and to once again be the New South champion.
Well, somebody's going to learn today regardless.
Well.
Whether it's Baron or
Cabana
Mandan.
Tell you what, Baron's learning today that Cabana Mandan has a lot of fighting spirit and he's not one to give up, that's for sure. Whoa!
Oh! And floors him with that European uppercut.
Oh!
Looking for that tombstone
pile driver tonight.
We've seen him do that multiple times here in New South.
Oh my God!
And drops Cabana Mandan right on the top of his head.
Cabana Mandan a couple inches shorter than he was when he came in. And...
Oh! He ain't got much height to give away.
What do you say?
He will be the same height as Daniel Devine.
Baron getting that look on his face like, what have I got to do to this guy?
I don't know if that's frustration or desperation or maybe...
It's a mixture of both.
He's not quite sure what to do. Ripping the rest of that tape off.
Yes, he thinks if he gets that tape off, that'll be the key to... This is definitely frustration at this point, Matthew. Look at him. Oh, my God. I'm gonna say it once again. I don't know that Dump Sanders or one of CMD's friends doesn't need to come out here and stop this thing or something. I mean, clearly he's not going to give up, but at what point is enough enough?
The referee got to be on top of things.
Still
we've got
that
foot, though. Whoa!
A relative rookie of a referee who I don't know that will pull the trigger on making any decisions himself.
It's very true. Might be a little gun shy.
Exactly, because he don't want to be the guy who spoils the finals of the Hall's tournament.
But at what point is enough enough?
I mean, you got to think about Cabana Mandan's long-term health here, you know.
Live to fight another day, as they say.
Exactly.
Looking for another power bomb, and this might do it!
Yeah. Stay down, Dan. Stay down, man. No.
Slow to cover him, but still not enough. And now Baron definitely has to be frustrated.
What they've shown us here in the past minute, Matthew, there's been a lot of people talk a lot of smack on social media about, you know, what hoss means and, you know, whether the guys in this tournament are hosses. And both of these guys have shown by any definition they are a couple of hosses. They are fighting damn near to the death, it seems. Look at that.
Oh, wow.
That's how you got, you bitch.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Competitive man Dan, wow. Not one to use that type of language, is fired up.
Oh! Still on his feet, though.
Uh-oh. This can't be good.
One of the most mild-mannered men in professional wrestling.
I know. I mean, you look up nice guy in the wrestling dictionary, you're going to see CMD.
In a bad place here, though.
Well, Baron Black is getting ready to put this one to bed right here. Hopefully, Cabana Man Dan can fight. Wait a minute. Is this going to be? Oh! Oh, my God.
Super surfs up.
Surfs up.
Can he get there?
Rope.
Cover.
Hook that leg.
Nice.
Oh, my God. I cannot believe what we just witnessed, Matthew.
That super surfs up. Turn the table.
Oh, my God.
Bruce Grubbs and all, Cabana Man Dan going all the way through to the finals and taking home Hoss. Eliminated last year in the first round by Fred Yehi.
I know they used to call Michael Elgin unbreakable. You might have to call Cabana Man Dan that now. This is amazing.
It's insane the amount of punishment that he withstood just tonight, not to mention last night with that hammer attack.
Friends and peers and
coalition, if you will.
Look at that jacket. We're talking about a man who 6 months ago lost everything. He was just Dan. He wasn't even Cabana Man Dan anymore, and it was to the point, had he lost a match, his career was going to be over.
And just a couple months ago.
Just a couple of months ago, and here he stands atop New South.
Oh, it's Charlie
Mitchell. There's a new champion out here.
Aaron just crawling to the back.
Now what's Tyler Matrix's motives for coming out here, Matthew?
He doesn't look like he's in any position to throw down at this point.
Yeah, I mean, I'm assuming
either
it's congratulatory, but, you know, I don't know.
Looks like he's struggling under the weight of that big belt.
He is. Poor Dan right now with... get crushed under that belt at this point after all he's been through.
For all these years, people think the man
Had here.
Matthew, there's people who at times have questioned the reality of professional wrestling. That was a very, very real moment for Man to Man Dan, and I'm glad we got to be here to see it. Look at it, man.
We appreciate each and every one of you for watching this Hoss tournament. Had a great time, and Commander Man Dan.
Thank you for coming out
tonight. Oh, they cut the music. Commander Man Dan definitely deserves it. We hope you'd enjoy it. For Gene Jackson, I'm Matthew Glover. You guys have a good one.